Hello, welcome back to Transformation Ground Control, episode number 73. My name is Eric Kimberling, and I want to thank Kate Bush for providing that transition music there with Running Up That Hill. And if you're the reason we use that song is it's prominently used in season 4 of Stranger Things, or part 4 of Stranger Things on Netflix, if you're a fan of that show or if you watch that show. If you don't watch that show, I highly recommend it. It's a really good sort of sci-fi show that's a throwback to the 80s. Has really good music. It's resurrected songs like that Kate Bush song. There's prominent use of a lot of really good 80s music. So being such a big music fan, I tend to love that. And the reason I got so into the show more recently is my wife and I actually watched the show as it was coming out, the first 3 seasons. And about 6 months ago, or not even 6 months ago, maybe 3 months ago, our 13-year-old son decided that he wanted to try watching Stranger Things. And we had tried to get him to watch it when he was, you know, 9 or 10 or however old he was when the show came out, but he was terrified by it and didn't want to see it, and neither did our older son. And just more recently decided, hey, I want to try Stranger Things, because he had seen a bunch of TikTok videos about Stranger Things. So we went back and binge-watched with him all the first 3 seasons again. And I liked it the first time I saw it, but I liked it a lot more the second time for some reason. It just resonated more with me the second time I watched it. Might have been partly because we did it more as a family with the 3 of us. My older son still isn't very interested in it, but you know, he's 15 years old and too cool for anything like that. So there's a lot of things that we do that he's not interested in, but that's okay. So anyway, so we got into the show and really enjoy it. And it's got a lot of not just good 80s not just 80s music references, but just everything feels like it's just, I mean, obviously the movie is set in the 80s, but there's a lot of references to everything from the opening credits looking like a Stephen King cover, book cover. I mean, the font, I think, is the exact font that was used in one or more Stephen King movies. There's just tons of references to, you know, E.T. and a lot of sci-fi shows from the 80s. A lot of really cool references to 80s stuff. So if you're a child of the 80s, or if you were around in the 80s like I was, it's a really good show. And the reason I'm talking about this in this podcast, you may wonder, what does this have to do with digital transformation? Is in the previous segment with Greg Benton, toward the end of that interview, I started talking about Stranger Things just coincidentally. And I thought, you know what, that's kind of an interesting thing to really build on and maybe unpack a little bit more in terms of how digital transformations in the digital transformation industry is a lot like Stranger Things. And I was talking in that previous segment about how it's almost like if you look at doing digital transformations right and the way things should be done, the way that's more effective, creates more value for organizations, versus the way that unfortunately most organizations operate, which is they do things the wrong way. They implement poorly. They spend too much time, too much money on the projects. They undermine business value. In many cases, they disrupt their own operations and actually create negative business value on top of the fact that they've also just invested heavily in new technology. And to me, it's sort of like the dichotomy between the regular world and the upside down world. If you're not familiar with the show, there's a regular world and then there's an upside down world. So for example, if you look behind me, there's green trees, there's a nice office building right behind me. My office looks pretty nice and spacious, but if you flip me into the upside down world, if I go to that upside down world, I'm in the same place, but it's dark and decrepit and gross and scary. And there's ominous music and monsters and stuff like that. And, not a fun place to be. And so it kind of reminds me of, the way a lot of digital transformations work. And the whole show is about, you know, sort of good versus evil, right and wrong, and that sort of thing. And I feel like a lot of times, you know, just to simplify some of the problems with the digital transformation space, that's one of the big challenges that organizations often have. So, you know, if you're not familiar with the show, or you just haven't watched the show yet, some of the other things, similarities that are worth noting is that in the show, there's some protagonists that are fighting these evil powers and trying to fight the monsters from the upside down world. You have characters, the main protagonists are a bunch of really smart but nerdy kids that play Dungeons and Dragons, and they end up being the protagonists and the main characters in the show, sort of fighting and solving the riddle of what this upside down world is. They rescue their friends from the upside down world. They rescue non-friends and try to rescue others from the upside down world as well. And then in the upside down world, there's a sort of a evil monster called Vecna. And there's also a Demogorgons as well. So, sort of monstrous sorts of villains that are trying to creep into the regular world to get people to take down into the upside down world. I suppose it's sort of like heaven and hell in some ways, sort of like they're trying to drag people down into hell in some ways. That might be a good analogy. But the one of the main protagonists is a character named L, which is short for 11. And her name is 11 because she was taken from her parents as a young child, and she was raised in a lab where they tried to give her, they successfully did give her and train her to have these supernatural powers. And the intent is, you know, to use it for evil. These aren't good people. These aren't people using superpowers for good. They're using it to do bad things in the world. And in many ways, I kind of view, I hate to say it, but I view the incumbents and sort of the traditional software vendors, especially the really big software vendors, the big system integrators, they're sort of creating a machine in that same way, that sort of lab environment where they're brainwashing people, creating bad habits in the industry that are creating a lot of problems in digital transformations. And it may sound like a conspiracy theory. It may seem like a stretch to some of you, you know, making this connection between Stranger Things and the digital transformation space. And it certainly is a very extreme, dramatized version or analogy that I'm trying to make here. But I think it's a good one in that because I think a lot of the industry does struggle with a lot of this stuff. And so these big ERP vendors, system integrators are oftentimes, training their people and creating armies of people that are out there peddling false messaging and messages that mismanage expectations and mislead, in many cases, organizations as they go through their digital transformation journeys. And they do it because they want to sell more software. And they sell more software. The more software they sell, the more money they make. And there's companies out there, not all the big software vendors and not all the system integrators are doing it, but the big ones certainly are. A lot of the big ones, if not most of them, are doing that sort of activity. I'd say the smaller and mid-size organizations in the space are a lot less likely to do that. When you look at some of the smaller and middle-tier software providers and system integrators, implementation partners, they're less likely to be as blatant about it. In some cases, they just aren't as competent or they don't have the skill sets needed to make a transformation successful. So they, in many cases, are contributing to failure, but not in a nefarious way. I would argue that some of the larger organizations, some of the larger players in our space are doing it in a nefarious way. They're doing it because they're out for self-interest and they're trying to sell software. And so, you know, one of the things that I think is great about our industry, one of the emerging trends, just to build on the conversation with Greg a few minutes ago, is that there are companies like ours, like Third Stage Consulting and others, that are independent, technology agnostic, not just focused on selling technology because we don't sell technology, but we're out there to help clients be more successful in their transformations. So in a lot of ways, it's like we're those nerdy kids that play Dungeons and Dragons, even though I don't know how to play Dungeons and Dragons, but I was a relatively nerdy kid growing up and focused more on school than anything else. Didn't play D&D because I was too busy studying. So I think that you could argue made me a nerd in a different sort of way. But that's one of the things to think about is when you're navigating digital transformations, you know, there is in many cases right and wrong, and I hate to say good and evil, that might be taking it a bit far, but there are right ways to do things. And there is not a one size fits all answer to everything. I will say that. So it's not like I can tell you that if you do A, B, and C, you're doing things good. If you do D, E, and F, you're doing things bad. There are some cases where that's true, but in many cases, it's sort of like a continuum. You're trying to choose the right answer for you as an organization that's somewhere on a continuum. And anyone that takes you too far to one extreme, one or the other, is probably leading you down the wrong path. And if we go back to the segment, the opening segment of this podcast episode, where we talked about Agile versus Waterfall, that was a good example of how, you know, in that discussion, I was saying that there's not a argument to be made, or I'm not trying to make an argument for or against Agile or for or against Waterfall deployment approaches. But what I am saying is if you pick one or the other and say that's the right answer for everyone, that in and of itself is the wrong answer. But instead, what you have to look at is where on that continuum do we fall? So I think that's really the sort of the difference that you have to look for. And that's a really subtle but really important difference and mindset shift that the industry needs to make. They need to stop doing the upside down world type stuff, to use the Stranger Things analogy again. They need to stop with the upside down world type stuff and giving these one size fits all cookie cutter sorts of answers that are meant to sell more software, and focus more on who is this company I'm dealing with? How can my software help them be more efficient and effective and create more business value? And how can I selectively, where appropriate, use my technology to help them get there? The problem is, in the self-interested mode that we're all in, oftentimes those organizations are trying really hard to push as much software and shove as much software down their throats as they can, and that usually just creates more problems than it does good for a lot of organizations. So anyway, great show, Stranger Things. I highly encourage you to check it out if you haven't seen it already. I'm a big fan, and hopefully this analogy has helped as well. So I'd love to hear your feedback too, by the way. If you agree with me, disagree, leave your comments in the chat below. I'd love to hear your feedback on what you think. Is this analogy relevant? And if so, how do you view the industry? How do you view it, especially if you're familiar with the show Stranger Things? How do you view the industry in terms of how it fits in the regular world and the upside down world and the whole analogy I've laid out here? Even if you totally disagree, I'd love to hear that too, because that's part of the discussion too. So we're going to shift gears a bit here in just a moment, and we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to have Khalid Morris on the show, and he's actually been on the show a couple of times in a few different formats. He's going to be on after a break, actually giving a presentation on cybersecurity and data management, which is always an important topic, an important consideration, especially in today's day and age. So we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be back with Khalid Morris on Transformation Ground Control.
Darling, you got to let me.